Chris.
I'm Kristen.
And we are Keto in the Country.
This is your channel for smart, healthy, whole food recipes.
And if you like that idea, be sure to hit that subscribe button. And if you want a recipe every time we come out with one, we try once a week, hit that little bell too.
Yes. So be sure to check out our website. That's where you'll find all of our recipes. You will find our blogs and nutritional articles.
Yeah, it's really good. Yes. I'm very proud of it. So
today, we are going to turn this into this. So we just wanted to take a minute and say thank you to all of our subscribers and our patrons. You guys make our day. To anybody who comments, thank you so much. Whether it's something instructive or whether it's somebody who's tried out a recipe, we appreciate it so much.
Yes.
Candy from North Carolina, you made our day yesterday.
She told us we were models. Okay, no. Maybe she didn't tell us we were models, but...
But thank you. It's so nice sometimes just to see something really sweet.
It is. And almost all our comments are really sweet.
Yes.
But... just one more thing before we start chopping is if you make one of our recipes, any one of them, it doesn't matter, send us a picture and we'll put it in one of our videos. So all it is really is roasted vegetables, but whatever vegetable you have in the refrigerator, we like these because they are all nutritionally dense.
Yes.
And for you vegetarians, you have full protein. You have the nuts and the cheese. The vegans just leave off the cheese and you've got a great meal full of protein.
Yes.
You can't lose with this.
You can't lose with this. And we can't forget about the mushrooms. Mushrooms are also great if you're vegetarian.
Yeah.
So
we keep this combination, well, not this combination of vegetables, but we keep a combination of roasted vegetables in our fridge at all times. We put them on top of our salads, cold.
Yes, as a side dish.
As a side dish with a hamburger or meatloaf, something like that, or just a standalone meal because of the cheese and the nuts.
Absolutely. It's even the perfect healthy snack. If you're somebody who snacks during the day, if you have this on hand, then you're less likely to cheat.
Yes, and we like the whole food. We like the fresh food.
Yes.
So here we go. We're going to start chopping all these vegetables.
Chopping, we are going to go ahead and transfer everything onto a baking sheet lined with parchment paper.
Mm-hmm.
So first, asparagus. Now, one of the interesting things that I read about asparagus was that when the asparagus is cooked is when it starts to activate all of the cancer-fighting properties.
Okay, because a lot of people worry about what's going to happen when you heat. Does it lose its vitamins or minerals or whatever? That's not the case with...
No.
Asparagus.
But the thing is, you want to keep in mind not to overcook it, because then it does release all of those nutrients into the water when you're steaming it or boiling it, whatever.
Okay, so next I'm going to put the zucchini on.
Yes.
Zucchini, if you didn't know, you don't think about it because it's green, but it actually has a ton of vitamin C. And it's not bad on carbs either.
No, it's not. And neither is asparagus. I think all of the vegetables that we're using today, you'll see that even the ones that have carbs, when you spread it out over like the different portions, it really isn't going to hurt you.
Yeah.
So peppers are full of vitamin C and also vitamin E. Now, one of the things about vitamin E is that when you prepare the peppers or even the asparagus with a fat, that fat, like the olive oil, is going to help your body to absorb that vitamin E.
Right. So this is just shaping. You can see how this is shaping up just to be a beautiful superfood to have on hand at all times.
Yes.
Okay, kale. Has protein. Did you know that?
I did not know that.
Did not know. Kale's full of protein and it's also absolutely full of potassium, which if you're having cramps, a lot of people on keto are having cramps because
yes.
it's those electrolytes again, you gotta keep up with them.
Right.
Okay, now the mushrooms.
We love mushrooms. These do have protein
just
also.
Because they're good. Look at that. That's
gorgeous.
Beautiful.
And lastly, we're going to chop up an onion, also toss that in there. And now, while many of you think that onions are a no-no, they're actually not. Onions are also full of vitamin C. They do have carbs, but like we said with the other vegetables, when you're spreading it out over however many servings, it's okay. And they add a ton of flavor and antioxidants.
I like the flavor of the onions because when you put them in the oven, they sort of curl up and turn brown a little bit.
Right. Delicious.
That's my favorite part.
Yes. And onions also fight inflammation. We love that. So We are going to throw some on there.
We forgot about them when we were chopping, so that's why we're doing this right now. No, we are not perfect.
What?
I know, what? And we're going to salt it. Yes. And you can put some basil on here. You can put oregano on here.
Any fresh herbs you have, if you have parsley on hand. So we'll just finish seasoning this with salt. We're going to pop it in the oven, and then we're on to...
Yes. Then we're on to our pesto, because once these are done, to make it just a meal within itself, we're going to make a beautiful pesto, and we're going to top it with the homemade pesto and some goat cheese.
Yes.
So pesto is so easy to make, and it's so delicious, and it's so much better than the store-bought. So we have a lot of basil outside, so we don't have any problems, but this is about 2 cups of basil. You just throw it in the food processor. Basil also has calcium and a lot of antioxidants, of course, because it's green. Now, the pine nuts add a beautiful buttery taste. We toasted them just a little bit before we put them in there, and they have tons of iron. I did not know this until today. So it's I put a third cup of pine nuts in there, a third cup of olive oil.
We love this olive oil. Christy gets it when she's overseas, when she's traveling. Yes. So
it's just, we know it's pure, we know it's organic.
Exactly.
And it's straight off the farm. And 1.5 to 2 cups of Parmesan. I love Parmesan. We both love Parmesan, so we put a lot in there. A little bit of salt.
On everything.
On everything. Salt to taste.
Yes.
Don't salt to our taste. Okay, we're just gonna pop it in there. So obviously we're not going to eat this much pesto in one sitting.
Although we could.
we could, but most people wouldn't. I'll put it that way. So you can always store them in little ice cube trays and then pop them in the freezer. Once they're frozen, you can put them in a little baggie and you can pop them on anything.
For all of you meal preppers, this is a go-to. It's perfect on anything as a side dish alone.
You could put it on chicken. You could use it as a side for meatloaf, which is what we're going to do later tonight.
Yes. Another great idea would be stuff it into a chicken.
Cut it in half. Oh my God, yes.
And then you get in your veggies, your protein. This meal's outrageous. You have to try it. If you do, be sure to take a picture and send it to us.
Yeah, we'd love to post it.
Yes.
So thanks again for watching. And oh, one more thing. If you have Amazon Prime, you need to watch the movie Fat Fiction. It is hands down one of the best documentaries about nutrition I've ever seen. There's Jason Fung, there's Mark Hyman, and some other people I can't think of right now. But Fat Fiction, you gotta watch it.
We're having a family movie night tonight. Maybe we'll have this to go with it.
Yes.
Thanks so much for joining us today.
Yeah, bye.
Bye. Also, they fight inflammation. So for all of you who,
who are fighting inflammation, but it actually has a ton of vitamin C.
And it's so delicious.
Yeah. And it's good.
Next, we have the orange and red bell peppers. Mm. And now these are full of vitamin C. And also,